End of chapter 20. Chapter 21. A Bashful Brother. With fast beating hearts they all rushed forward, and, beyond a group of stately metal trees, came full upon a most astonishing scene. There was Ruggedo in the hands of the officers of Oogaboo, a dozen of whom were clinging to the old gnome and holding him fast in spite of his efforts to escape. There also was Queen Anne, looking grimly upon the scene of strife, but when she observed her former companions approaching, she turned away in a shame-faced manner. For Anne and her officers were indeed a sight to behold. Her Majesty's clothing, once so rich and gorgeous, was now worn and torn into shreds by her long crawl through the tunnel, which, by the way, had led her directly into the metal forest. It was, indeed, one of the three secret passages, and by far the most difficult of the three. Anne had not only torn her pretty skirt and jacket, but her crown had become bent and battered, and even her shoes were so cut and slashed that they were ready to fall from her feet. The officers had fared somewhat worse than their leader, for holes were worn in the knees of their trousers, while sharp points of rock in the roof and sides of the tunnel had made rags of every inch of their once brilliant uniforms. A more tattered and woeful army never came out of a battle than these harmless victims of the rocky passage. But it had seemed their only means of escape from the cruel Gnome King, so they had crawled on, regardless of their sufferings. When they reached the metal forest, their eyes beheld more plunder than they had ever dreamed of, yet they were prisoners in the huge dome, and could not escape with the riches heaped about them. Perhaps a more unhappy and homesick lot of conquerors never existed than this band from Oogaboo.